Welcome to Suncoast. My last stop on my coach bus trip this summer was the Postojna Cave. Postojna is on the Pivka River and it's located midway between Trieste, Italy and Ljubljana, the capital of Slovenia, about 45 kilometers or 26 miles from each city. The coach bus stopped at the parking lot near the cave. The group walked to the entrance to the cave and the complex that has restaurants and other facilities. The trip through the cave is about 90 minutes and it starts with a 3.7 kilometer long journey on a double track cave railway, which is unique in the world. Postojna is largely known for two tourist attractions that are special. Prajama Castle, which I didn't see and I plan to see sometime in the future, and the Postojna Cave, which is truly a special place. The Postojna Cave is considered one of Europe's best examples of the karst phenomena. The karst phenomena refers to a landscape that is made up of limestone. Limestone, sometimes known as chalk or calcium carbonate, is a soft rock that dissolves in water. Rainwater seeps into the rock and erodes the rock slowly. Karst landscapes can be dissolved from the top or inside a rock. The 24 kilometers or 15 mile long cave system was carved by the Pivka River over millions of years. Stalactites are formed from the ceiling of the cave as the calcium is dissolved and drips down from the ceiling, adding more and more material, growing in length and getting closer to the floor of the cave. Stalagmites are formed as the dissolved calcium drops down to the floor of the cave and starts growing upward towards the ceiling. This process takes place over millions of years, and sometimes the stalagmites and stalactites unite to form a column. There are many beautiful formations of stalagmites, stalactites, columns, and combination of these structures in curtains and other beautiful formations in the cave. In 1872, rails and rail cars were installed. They were pushed by the tourist guides themselves until the beginning of the 20th century when a locomotive was installed. In 1884, a lighting system was installed. One last thing I want to talk about regarding the cave in Postojna are the Proteus creatures that live in the cave, which I found absolutely amazing and I didn't know anything about before I visited the cave. As I'm talking about this, I'm thinking about my daughter because she raises bearded dragons and I'm sure she would find the Proteus fascinating. The Proteus anguinus goes by a bunch of names, including Olm and Baby Dragon, called by people in Postojna because it's believed that it's the baby of a dragon. Proteus is a salamander that is adapted to the cave setting. They lack pigmentation and eyesight and rely completely on their well-developed sense of smell and hearing. The cave environment is well suited for the baby dragon, with constant temperatures between 8 to 11 degrees Celsius and with plenty of oxygen. The Proteus can consume large amounts of food and survive without eating for up to 10 years. I enjoyed Postojna Caves and I recommend them. Thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed my video clip. Please subscribe.